Meghan responds to claims she attacked from Kensington Palace staff. Duchess of Sussex saddened by attack on her character. The Duchess has issued a statement. Meghan is saddened by claims in The Times that she was the subject of a bullying complaint while living at Kensington Palace with husband Prince Harry. In response to the claims, which were published on Tuesday evening, and refer to an alleged complaint from many years ago, her spokesperson told, "The Duchess is saddened by this latest attack on her character, particularly as someone who has been the target of bullying herself, and is deeply committed to supporting those who have experienced pain and trauma. She is determined to continue her work building compassion around the world, and will keep striving to set an example for doing what is right and doing what is good." The reports comes just days before Meghan and Harry's highly anticipated interview with Oprah Winfrey is aired. The CBS two-hour special will be screened on Sunday in the US and is expected to be shown in the UK on the 8th of March. Last week, two 30-second excerpts from the sit-down Oprah with Meghan and Harry, a CBS primetime special, were released. The first clip shows Oprah questioning Meghan whether she was silent or silenced, and later asks the Duchess, almost unsurvivable, "Sounds like there was a breaking point." The video then cuts to Harry, who remarks, "My biggest fear was history repeating itself." At the end of the first preview, Oprah, who is also one of Meghan and Harry's neighbors in their Montecito neighborhood in California, told the couple, "You have said some pretty shocking things here." In the second clip, the prince says he is grateful to have had Meghan's support during his exit from royal life, while also drawing comparisons with his late mother, Princess Diana. He tells Oprah, "I'm just really relieved and happy to be sitting here, talking to you, with my wife by my side. Because I can't begin to imagine what it must have been like for her, going through this process by herself, all those years ago. Because it has been unbelievably tough for the two of us, but at least we had each other." A spokesperson for the Duke and Duchess of Sussex says Meghan will keep striving to set an example for doing what is right and doing what is good. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry are set to sit down with Oprah Winfrey for a much-anticipated interview on Sunday. And 5 days before it is scheduled to air, a new report is leveling allegations of bullying by the Duchess of Sussex. On Tuesday, The Times in the UK claimed that the Duchess of Sussex faced a bullying complaint made by one of her close advisors during her time as a working royal at Kensington Palace, something her office has strongly refuted. "The Duchess is saddened by this latest attack on her character, particularly as someone who has been the target of bullying herself and is deeply committed to supporting those who have experienced pain and trauma," a spokesperson for the Duke and Duchess of Sussex said in a statement obtained. "She is determined to continue her work building compassion around the world, and will keep striving to set an example for doing what is right and doing what is good," says one observer of the timing of the new report given the looming Oprah Winfrey interview. "The whole thing reminds me of an old rugby saying, get your retaliation in first." The complaint, which The Times reports was made in October 2018 by the couple's former communications secretary Jason Nuoff, claimed that Meghan drove two personal assistants out of the household and undermined the confidence of a third staff member. The Times says Nuoff submitted the complaint in an effort to protect palace staffers who were allegedly bullied by the Duchess of Sussex, at times reduced to tears. One royal aide, who anticipated a confrontation with Meghan, is alleged to have told a colleague, "I can't stop shaking." In February 2019, several of Meghan's friends told that the Duchess herself had been the victim of global bullying by the tabloid press, with a friend noting, "Meghan's silently sat back and endured the lies and untruths." One report in November 2018 in the Mail on Sunday branded the Duchess, who is the first woman of color in the royal family in modern history, Hurricane Meghan, and claimed that she bombarded aides with 5 a.m. emails and texts. In the story published in The Times on Tuesday, a source says that Harry pleaded with Nuoff not to pursue the HR complaint. According to The Times, lawyers for Meghan and Harry deny that any meeting took place, or that the Duke of Sussex would have interfered with any staff matter. Nuoff reportedly sent an email to Simon Case, Prince William's private secretary at the time, and now the cabinet secretary, after conversations with Samantha Carruthers, the head of HR. Case then forwarded it to Carruthers. In his email, North said Carruthers agreed with me on all counts that the situation was very serious. He added, I remain concerned that nothing will be done. A spokesperson for the Sussexes told The Times in a statement, let's just call this what it is, a calculated smear campaign based on misleading and harmful misinformation. We are disappointed to see this defamatory portrayal of the Duchess of Sussex given credibility by a media outlet. It's no coincidence that distorted several-year-old accusations aimed at undermining the Duchess are being briefed to the British media shortly, before she and the Duke are due to speak openly and honestly about their experience of recent years. Buckingham Palace recently confirmed in a statement that the couple, who left full-time royal work in March 2020 and recently announced that they are expecting their second child, will officially not be returning to their royal roles. The palace statement added that Harry's grandmother Queen Elizabeth decreed that in stepping away from royal work, it is not possible to continue with the responsibilities and duties that come with a life of public service. In response, the couple stated, we can all live a life of service. Service is universal. Thank you for watching. If you like our video, would you please help us like, share and subscribe our channel? Wish you happy to see our videos. Thank you very much.